Hello, this is Jeff Robertson with Penton Audio USA and Atis Electronics. This is a short sales tutorial video on the UAP G2, or better known as our Universal Audio Processor second generation. Now, the Atis Electronics UAP G2 is our baseline commercial audio digital signal processor. It has some of our same global features that you will find across all of our DSPs within the Atis Electronics Penton Audio family. And some of these global features include 5-year across-the-board factory warranty. They all are drag-and-drop DSP with the software available for free download at our website. You can select between 48 kHz or 96 kHz sampling rate on all our DSPs. Every single one of our DSPs contain digital audio message storage in various sizes and capacities. Every one of our DSPs contain an event scheduler, so you can have messages, presets, control outputs. All those things can be set up as timed events. All of our DSP audio input cards have selectable 48-volt DC phantom power that is selectable per input, not per card or group of inputs, but actually per input within the same card. So those are some of the global features that you'll find across the board on all the Atis Electronics Penton Audio digital signal processor family. So now let's look at some of the unique features that we have here on our UAP, or Universal Audio Processor. As we go in and we'll zoom here on the back of the unit, the first thing we have on the back of the unit is the audio input-output configuration. We have right here 4 slots, and each one of these slots can be occupied by an audio input card. Each one of these cards is 4 channels, so this is configurable in 4 channels to a maximum of 16 channels. Now, you can get this in 0x16, 4x12, 8x8, 12x4, or 16x0 audio input-output configuration. One thing to remember is the dealer cost on this unit is one flat fee no matter how you get the configuration. A 0x16 box is the same price as an 8x8 or 16x0 box. Some other hardware features that you'll find on the UAP is that we have 16 control inputs built right into the box. Now, these inputs are field configurable in the software to be TTL logic. You got your 0 to 5 volt DC trigger inputs. They can be normally open or normally closed configured, as well as they can be configured for analog, so you can use your 10K analog controls or your variable resistor controls. We also have built into the box 8 control outputs built in. The 8 control outputs can be set up for normally open or normally closed operation within the software. We also have in here our RS-485, and the RS-485 contains the 45 data as well as the 24-volt DC power, which is used to power and control or talk to many of our various smart remotes that is in another video, and also at the end of our DSP catalog, which I'm referring to right here. We also have built in a Form C relay, so if there's a problem with the unit, it locks up, goes down, loses power, whatever, it will change the state of this relay, so you can actually monitor the UAP's integrity through third-party controllers. You can monitor it through, you know, any fire security panel, through supervisory if you want. Anything you need that you want to know, that monitor the integrity of the system because they're in a data closet or electrical closet somewhere, you can use this Form C relay on the default relay for that purpose. Now, going to the front of the unit, you see we have the LEDs. These LEDs correspond with the 4 audio slots that we have right over here. And with these LEDs, they give us several indications. One is that the green LEDs signify that that slot is occupied by an input card, and the orange LEDs signify that that slot is occupied by an output card. Also, the LEDs will flash and blink as signals present on both the input and outputs, as well as they will flash red when you reach a clip or overload situation. The other thing that most people really, really, really like about the UAP, and is one of our most desired features, is that we have 8 front panel knobs. These 8 knobs are software or virtual analog control knobs that are mapped within the software just like you would any control input on the system. So now you got 16 control inputs as well as you got 8 virtual analog control inputs on the front. It doesn't occupy any of the control inputs on the back. Now, these knobs do absolutely nothing right out of the box. They are 100% assignable to whatever leveling or rotary control function that you have within any component within your design. Any of these knobs can be mapped to a single level controller, as well as they can control multiple level controls or rotary controls. So let's say, for instance, you have a stereo input and the right and left channels are occupied 2 audio inputs. Well, you can have one knob mapped to both the right and left channels controlling the stereo input together. Another common use of this feature is many users out there will actually configure a knob to be their master audio output. So it controls all their mapped audio outputs. Once they set their general levels, they can ramp them all up and down at the same ratio. So that's another common feature of the knobs. Another more important feature of these knobs, they are 100% scalable. And in that I mean our input sensitivity is negative 54 dB to 0 dB. But we have level controls also within the design that go from negative 90 dB on up to a positive 20 dB. You can actually scale a knob for any of these leveling controls to say you want negative 10 to positive 10 dB or negative 3 to positive 8 dB. You can scale these to whatever you want to give the user control of. So you can give them as much control, as little control, or absolutely no control whatsoever. That's some of the hardware features that are found on the outside of the box. There are also some really nice hardware features that are inside the box. One is the fact that the audio input and output cards are 100% field configurable. So let's say you order an 8x8 box, you get out to the job site, and they made some changes, and now you need, say, a 12x4 box. Well, all you have to do is, you know, order the audio input or output cards as needed, pop the top, they're plug-and-play boards, and once you get the configuration you want, power the system up, reconfigure, and you're done. You don't have to send the unit back to change the configuration. The UAP also has a 1,596 megaflop Shark Core DSP engine, so it's a very powerful DSP engine. With that being said, let's look at some of the software components that we'll find inside the UAP. Now, here's just a sample design that I have. And as you can see over here to the left, there are a ton of different drag and drop components. Some of the more common components that you're used to seeing in any drag and drop DSP, plus some very unique features. One is we have page controllers. We have microphone paging stations out there that talk either RS-45 or their HTML browser-based touchscreen microphone paging stations. Well, these all run through our local page controllers. The other thing that we have, as you see here, is our message player. Just like every DSP in the Atis family, they all contain digital audio storage files, and these audio files are accessed via the message player. The message player in the UAP actually has two output nodes, so we can play two simultaneous messages, or you can route different messages differently and give different messages higher priorities or lower priorities over other messages. What we also have in here, as I mentioned, across all of our DSPs is what we call an event scheduler. And the event scheduler will allow us to have messages to be timed events. You can have messages set up to be repeaters. So every 7 minutes, play the no smoking message, or every 10 minutes, play the loading zone only message, or whatever. Or you can have time messages like at 12 o'clock Monday through Friday, play the break message or whatever. But the event schedule also does more things than just time message events. It also will give you time preset features, and you can also have control outputs be timed events like unlocking doors, turning off lights, what have you. So keep that in mind as well. Some of the other software features we have on this DSP, we have 32 master presets and 16 sub presets per master. Now, a master preset is any design change whatsoever, wiring, any kind of design change. So you can have 32 totally complete different design changes stored within a single UAP. With every one of these 32 master presets, you can have up to 16 sub presets. And a sub preset is characterized as any change to an element, you know, within a component, volume change, muting buttons, selector switches, any adjustment to the gains or filters or anything like that, or EQs. These are what we call element changes, and you can have these changes via the sub preset. So 32 masters, 16 sub presets. So there you have it. Those are some of the hardware and software features of the UAP G2 audio digital signal processor from Atis Electronics. You can find more information for the Atis Electronics in our audio DSP catalog, which I'm referring to right here, which also contains all the DSPs that we have within the Atis Electronics family, including our ECS echo canceling system, as well as our LAP, our linked audio processor, and our voice evac mass notification system controller, which is also a drag and drop, better known as our IDA 8 system. If you have any questions about pricing or further information, or you want to get your hands on the catalog, you can download the catalog for free at our website at www.penton-usa.com or contact your local rep. Thank you and have a terrific day.